You know, the first three albums, for instance, we would literally show up in a room and it was almost as if the songs were already written. That's why I like to call Black Sabbath a phenomenon rather than a band. Although it is a rock and roll band, there's a phenomena involved there where that stuff just comes from somewhere. And it just so happened that we happen to be the ones that it came to.
Robert Johnson is considered the king of the Delta Blues. He's also considered the father of rock and roll. It is very significant that Johnson would be considered the father of rock and roll, as it is alleged that he had sold his soul to Satan in Clarksdale, Mississippi, in exchange for guitar playing abilities and worldwide fame. It was after Johnson made his alleged pact with Satan that he became the king of the Delta Blues. Bluesmaster B.B. King said, quote, as a musician, Robert Johnson had it all.
I think he's the greatest folk blues guitar player that ever lived, and the greatest singer, the greatest writer.
You know, you think you were getting a handle on playing the blues, and then to hear Johnson, you're like, whoa, there's a long way to go yet.
It's still the most powerful cry that I think you can find in music of the human voice.
Blues master and Johnson's mentor, Son House, said of him before Johnson's transformation, he sat at our feet and played during the break and such another racket you've never heard. Son House said he made the audiences mad with his racket. Son House went on to say of Johnson before he made his alleged pact with Satan that he was a talentless and even an irritating guitar player.
But he followed me and Willie around on Saturday night, yeah, Willie Brown. And every time we stopped for rest and sit there, we'll get out over in the corner or something and go out to catch air, you know, get the guitar and be trying to play it and be just noising the people, you know. And the folks would come out and say, why don't y'all, some of y'all go in there and make that boy put that, get that thing down, he's running us crazy. Finally, he left, he run off from his father and mother. And he went over in Arkansas someplace. He was gone about 6 to 8 months.
It was during this period of 6 to 8 months that it is said that he made his pact with Satan on the crossroads of Highway 49 and 61 in Clarksdale, Mississippi. It was at these crossroads where the legendary experiences of Johnson trading in his eternal soul for temporary fame was said to have taken place in Clarksdale, Mississippi.
Well, they say you sold yourself to the devil, and that's what they say.
I heard a lot of people say that he sold himself to the devil, went to the crossroads, and all that.
After Johnson's alleged pact with Satan, everything changed, as Johnson went from being the worst blues guitarist in a matter of months to the best. Some musicians who knew Johnson claimed that Johnson himself admitted that he sold his soul to Satan.
He said he done that, went to the crossroads.
Son House said that when Johnson returned after 6 to 8 months, everything changed as Johnson was transformed almost before their very eyes.
And he come back. When he come back, me and Willie Brown was playing out there, and he walked in. He said, can I hit a little bit? I said, nah, don't come back with that, Robert. I said, you know the people don't want to hear that racket. He said, let them say what they want to say. I want you to see what I like.
Son House said when he finished, all of our mouths were standing open. They couldn't believe what they were hearing. Son House declared emphatically, quote, he sold his soul to the devil to play like that. The Rock and Roll Hall of Fame has stated that Robert Johnson's songs are, quote, the bedrock upon which modern blues and rock and roll were built. He's not only declared to be the father of rock and roll, but the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame says that Robert Johnson stands at the crossroads of American music, much as a popular folk legend has it. He once stood at Mississippi Crossroads and sold his soul to the devil in exchange for guitar playing powers. Incredibly, Robert Johnson went from a guitarist who couldn't play a lick in a matter of months to a guitarist who, like a medium, didn't even have to practice as he channeled music from the spirit world at will.
I never seen him have to practice. Anything like that. Never seen him sit down and learn a song. He already knew it. Once he attempted to play it, he knew it. He had a built-in computer. Everything he heard was there. All he had to do was punch the button.
Whether or not the crossroads of Highway 49 and 61 are the exact place that Robert Johnson sold his soul, we cannot know for sure. But one thing is clear, Johnson had indeed given his soul to Satan. This is brought out in his own lyrics, which testify to this.
Early this morning, he knocked upon my door. And I said, hello, Satan, I believe it's time to go. Me and the devil were walking side by side. I'm going to beat my woman until I get
sad. Robert Johnson had a genuine fear of Satan coming to collect his soul, which is vividly recounted in songs like Hellhound on My Trail. Selling one's soul to Satan is a thread that runs through the history of rock and roll from Robert Johnson until present. Bob Dylan sings a takeoff on this theme on Highway 49, and Eric Clapton sings Crossroads, which seems to be a lament for having once sold one's soul. Ginger Baker, formerly of Clapton's group Cream, says of Cream, quote, "It happens to us quite often. It feels as though I'm not playing my instrument. Something else is playing it, and that same thing has played all three of our instruments. That's what I mean when I say it's frightening sometimes. Maybe we'll all play the same phrase out of nowhere. It happens very often with us."